I want to join the Democrats and talk about their favorite subject, race. Specifically, this white colonialism, slavery, white privilege stuff that we hear about all the time. Now, white colonialism, absolutely true, especially we're talking about Native Americans. The very definition of colonialism is where one group of people takes the political control of another group of people, they bring in their settlers, and then they exploit economically the whole thing. Whites did that, okay, with the Native Americans. Absolute fact, historical truth. Then you have the slavery issue. Without question, again, we know this happened. It's so terrible, there are no words in the English language to adequately talk about how terrible that it was. But I got to mention this. Today, it's time to get over it. I'm really tired of hearing how slavery and white colonialism and white privilege is holding back, whether it be an African-American or women or whatever. It's just not true anymore. We need to understand the historical significance of it, but it's time to move on. And you know what, this white privilege thing, I've said this before, I'm a white guy. I've never experienced it. I don't know what it is. I mean, I've been turned down for a loan from a bank before, and everything I've had in life, whether it be education or work or whatever, I have had to work my tail off. I would love to get me some white privilege. I think most of it is strictly baloney. It's baloney. Now I want to bring up something else. It's just a weird, odd phenomenon. And it's this. We all know what technology has done for our nation's economy, for our jobs, creating millionaires, I mean the rest. But the phenomenon is this. All the technology companies, the big ones, all of them, were created, developed, led by white guys. Every single one of them. I mean, go through the latest list. Google, Facebook, Instagram, LinkedIn, you know, Tesla, Uber, Airbnb. Go back a little further. Bring in Microsoft and Apple, Intel, Oracle. Bring in the retailers, you know, Best Buy, Walmart. Even bring in the internet. Give Al Gore credit for starting it. Every one of those companies started by white guys. And so I want Democrats or someone who is just so into this racial stuff to please explain to me how any of those men used white privilege, or it was because of slavery or white colonialism back in the past, that made it possible for them to do this. I just don't see it. Look at Bill Gates and Zuckerberg. They did come from family of means, so that was certainly a privilege, not necessarily because they were white, I don't think. They both went to Harvard. Gates went as a pre-law student, Zuckerberg as a psychology student. They both dropped out because of their ideas and their entrepreneurial spirit, their work ethic. Boom, they're both two of the richest men in the world now. And actually, I think that's a secret for all of us. The work ethic, you know, the entrepreneurial spirit, got to think and come up with ideas. I've done that. I've done pretty good with the ideas, the hard work. I haven't been successful. Okay, so it's just one of those things. I don't know why all the technology companies that I mentioned, even more, were all started by white guys. No blacks, no women. I don't know why. I can say what it's not. It didn't happen because they were white. That's the point I really want to make. And let me say this. Democrats would suggest that we need to equal this out, make it fair. So some of those companies need to be led by blacks and women now, so it could be more, you know, whatever. That's such baloney. I hate it when I hear that. What I would love to see is some black guys create some companies that would be as successful. And the same thing for women. Can you imagine what would happen to our economy and our country if we had triple the companies that would come to be so successful that we have now with the white guys? So, you know, for me, the issue is not race. The issue is just the simple stuff that makes any individual successful. So can we get off the racial stuff for a while and just work together that every person has an opportunity to pursue happiness in their own way? And out of that, a lot of people are going to be real successful. That's America.